a right aortic arch with an aberrant left subclavian artery is where you have the aortic arch that now comes out of the right side, goes around to the right of the trachea, and then descends down the descending aorta. The problem is frequently when you have that right aortic arch, you have the blood vessel that comes off behind the trachea and the airway that go to the left arm. And that blood vessel frequently compresses on the backside of the esophagus and airway, causing compression. So a right aortic arch with an aberrant left subclavian artery can cause pressure on the backside of the esophagus. And what makes that a so-called vascular ring is it also often has a ligament that forms between that aberrant subclavian artery to the pulmonary artery. And that gives you this so-called ring-like structure.
The right aortic arch with an aberrant left subclavian artery and left ligamentum completes the ring or the circle, involves a treatment usually with a left thoracotomy or an incision in the child's left side and back and division of the left ligamentum, and also would be in division and reimplantation of the left aberrant subclavian artery.
The blood vessel, the main blood vessel of the heart, comes off and goes to the right of the airway and esophagus and then descends down, but the blood vessel that comes off going to the left arm comes behind that. So typically the approach, surgical approach for that type of lesion is to go through the left chest or a so-called left thoracotomy where we open up the rib space, spare the muscles and try to minimize the incision, and then we take that blood vessel, remove it from the aorta, and then reimplant it in the normal place where it comes off close to the left carotid artery. And by taking that blood vessel and moving it and reimplanting it into the left carotid, into the more normal position, we don't have that compression on the esophagus and airway. Another very important point of that operation, as many folks hear about, is a diverticulum called Kummerell's diverticulum, and that is frequently quite big. And so if that is not addressed at the same time, and you can have persistent symptoms without relief of the so-called dysphagia or tracheobronchomalacia. So it's really important that when surgery is done for a right aortic arch aberrant left subclavian with a Kummerell's diverticulum, to remove that diverticulum.
Making sure to not leave any residual diverticulum of Kummerell if one it were to exist, meaning trying to divide that aberrant artery as close as possible to descending aorta. Some kids may need a descending aortopexy, maybe moving that descending aorta off to the side on the spine to create more space for the airway. So we want to make sure that those are addressed in addition to just releasing the ring. In the case of the right aortic arch and aberrant left subclavian, that usually involves dividing and reimplanting that left subclavian artery into the common carotid artery.